In this video, we'll see how to work on the paragraphs, like paragraph formatting, left, right, alignment, coloring, and so on. So these are the topics which I'll be covering here. One is the paragraph formatting. The next one is line spacing, indents, sorting. Then I have the paragraph shading and the borders. So let us see that one by one. I'll start with the paragraph formatting. So for that, I have written some text here. Okay, some text is given here. So what I'll do is, now I'll try to format in the left, right, and center alignment. So I'll just keep my cursor at this place. If I keep my cursor, it says you are in this, it is selected. That means it is justified. So what exactly is justified? First, I'll explain this one. So if I click on left, if you observe here, the entire text comes on the left and this area is left. So that this area is, the space is left empty. So you see here, observe here, the space is left empty. That means it started the text from the left hand side. Now if I say, if I want to go from middle, so if you observe, from the left also the text is left, and from the right also the text is left, right? If I select the right option, from only the from the left hand side that space is left, but from the right hand side there is no space which is left. So the better one people use mostly is the left indent, but sometimes if you want this space to occupy, I mean this sentence to occupy the empty space, that time you can select this thing that is known as justify. So I'll just keep my cursor just to understand the shortcut and also what exactly it means. Justify means it will, you know, utilize the space which is given here. So if I click on that, observe, nothing will change on the left hand side, but right hand side this the space will be occupied. I'll just click on that. So you observe here, the three spaces are occupied. The last one, because the words are not there, so it is not occupying it. So this way it works on left, center, right, and also for the justify. So this is how we can work. But now the next one, if you want to give some line spacing, the line spacing between two lines in a paragraph. So what you can do is, I can just keep my cursor at any place. It will automatically apply line setting. So I'll select here the option as line spacing. So if I select here 1.5, between this line where my cursor is there and the next line, the line spacing is 1.5. If I select here, I do not want 1.5, I want 3. So you observe here, what is the line spacing? The line spacing for the entire paragraph has become as 3. So if you observe here, 3. If I click here, I can just reduce as 2. Okay, equal line spacing. You do not have to press enter every time and do it. So I'll just say, as I do not want line spacing, I want just normal, that is 1, right? And there are few more options like this. You can select from line spacing options or add space, and you can say add space before paragraph, remove spaces after paragraph. So you can work according to that thing. Next one is, if you want to color the paragraphs, how do you color it? Same way, I've just kept my cursor which is blinking. Now you can see there's a bucket symbol. In this bucket symbol, you can choose any color. Now you might think there are two buckets here. One is, this is for the text one, and this one is for the paragraph. So because it falls under the paragraph, so I'll select here, I'll choose any color, let's say the blue color. The cursor was blinking at the first place, but the entire paragraph got colored. So this way the paragraph color can also be done. I'll keep my cursor at this place and I'll put the color here. So this paragraph also got colored. I'll press Ctrl Z from my keyboard and we'll go back. So this is how we can color the text, that's the paragraph. Let's see the next one I have. We can work on the sorting, and also we can work on the bullets and numbering. Let us see what exactly sorting means is. If you observe, I have written some text that is Apple, Denmark, Estate, Finland, Germany, Boy and Capital. This text which is written, it is not in the sorted order. That means A, D, E, F, G, and after again it comes as B, right? So this is not in the proper sorting order. I can sort this text in Word also. Like we can do in the Excel, same I can do it here itself. So I can, first thing is, I need to select the text which I want to sort. So I'll select the text here. And you observe in the paragraph, here there's an option as sorting. It gives me a dialog box. It says you can do multi-level sorting. The multi-level sorting means, first sort this one, second do this, third do this, and you can click on OK. So that is multi-column sorting itself, multi-paragraphs you can say mostly. Now if I click on this drop down, it says not only paragraph, I do three things. First one is paragraph I can sort the headings, I can sort the different fields. Fields means in the tables you get that, those fields. So I'll say I want right now as paragraphs, that is the text which is given. It says I can also sort for you the numbers, dates and text. But right now I have a text here. So paragraphs I want to sort, that is the text. How do you want to sort? Do you want in the ascending or descending order? So I'll say yes, I want in the ascending order. So observe here, Apple, Denmark, the B word which is written as B boy, it will come in between A and D, right? So if I click on OK, you observe what will happen here. So you observe Apple boy, capital Denmark. So purposely I've written that text so it's easy to understand, A to G, all the alphabets. If you want in descending order, again do the same thing. Already it is selected. Just click on this descending because all the options are same itself. So I'll click on OK. So this way it has come in the descending order. So I hope you are able to understand sorting is also possible in Microsoft Word. Next is, this text is not in proper format. Why not I put some bullet points? Bullet points, it looks proper way. I'll just click on this place. On this place, this is nothing but a bullet point. You see that bullet points have come. If you want some fancy kind of bullets, so you can just click on this drop down. You can choose whatever bullets you want from here. And let's say if you want this kind of checklist, if you want some other kind of. So this way you can also select it. And you can work on PowerPoint or somewhere if you want. Copy paste and work on that. This is how it can work. Sometimes you don't need this bullet points. You want proper technical terms, like you want the numbering in 1, 2, 3, or you want in ABC or Roman numbers. So you can select from this next button. You can see there are different number formats available. So I can select normal 1, 2, 3, or you can select Roman numbers, or you can select this capital or small case alphabets. So I'll select here as number 1, 2, 3, and this way it can work. So in case if you want child and parent nested numbers, you can select this one, the child and parent numbers, and accordingly it can work. So that is one thing. Also, so this was the numbering and the bullets part. Also, one more thing I like to show you here, that is indents. Indents means giving small spaces in a paragraph or in a sentences. I am talking about indents. If you observe here, that is nothing but indents. So if I click on this right indent like this, you observe what is happening to the text. The text is going on the right hand side on this place like this, increase indent. That means a small spaces are added. Sometimes you start a paragraph, you want a space in that paragraph with respect to the margin. Same way if you want, you can bring it back, that is left indent. So when you have a lot of text, you want to show something highlighted or you in between, that time you can use this indent portion. So I hope you are able to understand. So we have seen all the topics which are given here as paragraph formatting, line spacing, indents, sorting, we had paragraph shading, and the last one is left, that is the borders. So borders, how you can apply is, you just keep your cursor at any place, and if you want to apply a border, you just select this option here, and I'll select here as border. So wherever your cursor was there, the entire paragraph got bordered, right? Similarly, if you keep your cursor at this location anywhere, let's say, because this entire is one paragraph, this four sentences. If you want to put a paragraph to that, it's simple. You can just do it like this, okay? And you can select here as border. So you observe here, it is not giving for one line, but for the entire paragraph. So borders are easy. Keep your cursor and you can just click on this border. So the entire paragraph also is given here, but this both have combined together. So if you want specifically, you can select the text and also give a paragraph. So these are all the topics. So now I hope you have understood all the topics related to paragraph formatting. That's all for this video.